Just some thoughts. I'm listening to Abraham Lincoln, a tribute. Ashokan, farewell, provided by Manny 535. Okay. Some thoughts on what Tantra is, according to my humble opinion. Some thoughts on genuine Tantra. I would like to share a few thoughts on a very misunderstood subject matter, namely, that which is known as Tantra. Notwithstanding the many other definitions that any of you may read or hear about what it means, I will simply shed light on this sacred science in a way that I haven't seen or heard very much these days, especially while using the English tongue. For starters, let me state that the word Tantra is derived from the Sanskrit root tan, which means to spread, as in the spreading of knowledge. The suffix tra is from the root to save. In other words, Tantra means that spreading of pure knowledge which saves, or rather, preserves the essence of our quintessential being throughout the cycles of time and upon the canvas of space. The Kamika Agama, a tantric writing, says, Tanoti vipula nartan tatva mantra samanvitam Trananca kurute yasmat tantram ityabidyate. It is called Tantra because it promulgates great knowledge concerning tatva, the category of things, and mantra, the science of the word, because it saves. And now I will simply state that which should be evident. Nevertheless, I still say it because there are those hearing me that won't understand, and so it is for their ears that I speak, not for those who are full of themselves, so proud as they are by dint of their accumulated store of religious and or metaphysical data. What I want to say is there are seemingly endless tantric lineages, and that they all profess dedication to Shiva-Shakti in one way or another, differing just as widely as all the sundry Christian denominations do. However, I didn't come to this world, taking birth in this body, in order to debate with religious and or occult intellectuals. No, I just came in order to spread and share a very simple message that nevertheless overwhelms me because of its sublime greatness. In a nutshell, Shiva and Shakti are one, and he, she who worships one necessarily worships the other. I would like to say that in my book, Mahavishnu and Sadashiva are one in the same, just as Krishna and his older brother Balaram are one in the same. I would also like to remind every know-it-all out there that according to the ancient Bhagavata Purana, this planet was once called Jambudvipa. I would like to close by quoting a tantric scripture known as the Samohana Tantra, which says, without Prakriti, nature, samsara, the world, cannot be. Without Purusha, spirit, true knowledge cannot be attained. Therefore, both should be worshipped, Mahakali, Mother Nature, and Mahakala, Father Spirit. Thank you. Om Namah Shivaya. Hare Krishna. La Ferefun Orishan La.